Wake up, please. Şabab. Sleeping? Tired? Yalla, may Allah bless you. Zakum Allah khair. Inshallah, we'll finish. Then you'll do the exam. Which point now? Yes, point number 127. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to everyone, not only to his people, to Quraysh, for everyone. So Islam for the Arabs and non-Arabs. وَافْتَرَضَ عَلَى طَاعَتِهِ وَافْتَرَضَ اللَّهُ طَاعَتَهُ عَلَى جَمِيعِ الثَّقَلَيْنِ. طيب. Allah enjoined obedience to him upon all of the الثقلين. It means jinn and ins. What is the proof? The proof, O Muhammad, O mankind, verily I am sent to you all as the messenger of Allah. يا أيها الناس قل يا أيها الناس إني رسول الله إليكم جميعا. الناس is a general word, all people. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was sent to all people. وَأَكْمَلَ اللَّهُ بِهِ الدِّينِ. Allah perfected the religion through him. And the proof, okay. Now the religion is perfect or imperfect? Complete or not complete? Our religion, Islam, just complete, perfect. What is the proof? Allah says in Surah Al-Ma'idah, الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي. الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي. This day I have perfected your religion for you, completed my favor upon you. So don't think that there is a missing point in Islam. Oh, in Islam, this point is not explained. We don't know the rules of everything is perfect and complete. Alhamdulillah. In Islam, everything is completed. طيب. والدليل, sorry. اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم إسلام دينا. Then he said, والدليل على موته. The evidence for his death. يعني the Sheikh wants to emphasize the point of the Prophet ﷺ passed away. He's not alive with us now. Okay, some people think that we keep this chair empty, the Prophet ﷺ will come to sit with us sometime, then he will go to another masjid. A'udhu billah. A'udhu billah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his grave. طيب. What is the proof that he is dying? He passed away. إِنَّكَ مَيِّتْ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ. Verily, O Muhammad, will die, and verily, they too will die. So he passed away, and also he'll pass away. We'll die. He died sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and also we will die. وَالنَّاسُ إِذَا مَاتُوا يُبْعَثُونَ. When people die, they will thereafter be resurrected. Okay, so after death, that's it? No, it is not the end. It is not the end. There is something also after that. What is after that? الْبَعْثُ, the resurrection. مِنْهَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ وَفِيهَا نُعِيدُكُمْ وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُكُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى. They are of the earth, we created you, and into it we shall return you, and from it we shall bring you out once again. وقول تعالى, and also, والله أنبتكم من الأرض نباتا ثم يعيدكم فيها ويخرجكم إخراجا. And Allah has brought you forth from the earth, afterwards he will return you into it, and then will definitely bring you forth again on the day of resurrection. طيب. So this is one of the yes.
Sometimes they say,
We ask them, what is the proof? The Prophet ﷺ passed away, but his soul is alive and answering the dua. What is the proof that his soul is answering the dua? As simple as that. Ask them. Ask them. Okay. And also we have the proof against them. إِنَّكَ لَا تُسْمِعُ الْمَوْتَ وَلَا تُسْمِعُ الصُّمَّ الدُّعَى إِذَا وَلَّوْ مُدْبِرِينَ. You cannot make the dead people to hear. Okay, and also another ayah. وَلَوْ سَمِعُوا مَسْتَجَابُوا لَكُمْ وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يَكْفُرُونَ بِشِرْكِكُمْ وَلَا يُنَبِّئُكَ مِثْلُ خَبِيرٍ. They cannot hear. And if they hear, they cannot answer you. So we have clear ayah that the Prophet ﷺ cannot hear. Okay, even if we agree that he can hear us, but he cannot answer. He cannot answer. Okay. And if he can answer, okay, did the companions ask the Prophet ﷺ? Some battles happened at the time with the companions. They did not go to the grave of Rasulullah ﷺ saying, oh, Rasulullah, help us. They did not ask him. I know they will use not authentic hadith. Because this is their way. They use not authentic hadith. Then he said, وَبَعْدَ الْبَعْثِ مُحَاسَبُونَ وَمُجْزِيُونَ. After being resurrected, they will be held to account and recompensed for their deeds. And the proof is his saying, subhanahu wa ta'ala, لِيَجْزِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسَاءُوا بِمَا عَمِلُوا وَيَجْزِيَ الَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا بِالْحُسْنَى. That he may requite those who do evil with what they have done and reward those who do good with what is best. Okay, so the life is not the end. There is a group of people called Ad-Dahriyun. What does it mean? Ad-Dahriyun, they believe in this world only. They don't believe what is after this world. They say, this life, ما هي إلا أرحام تدفع وأرض تبلع. They say, this life is wombs. We consider this life only wombs which push the children and earth which take the bodies. They don't believe in the afterlife. Okay, of course, this is kufr. This is the way of the kuffar, like Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab. No, we believe there is a life after death. There is something called the barzakh. Barzakh means the barrier between the dunya and the akhirah. Then it means the life in the grave. After the life of the grave, the life in the akhirah. Okay, to the paradise or to the hellfire. Then he said, وَمَنْ كَدَّبِ الْبَعْثِ كَفَرْ. One who denies the resurrection commits disbelief. What is the proof? زَعَمَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَلَّا يُبْعَثُوا. زَعَمَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَلَّا يُبْعَثُوا. The disbelievers pretend that they will never be resurrected. So the one who claims, no, there is no life after this life, then he is kafir. He is kafir. We as Muslims, we believe there is something after the life, after our death. وَأَرْسَلَ اللَّهُ جَمِيعَ الرُّسُلُ مُبَشِّرِينَ وَمُنْذِرِينَ. Allah sent all the messengers as conveyors of glad tidings and warners. And the proof is this ayah. رُسُلًا مُبَشِّرِينَ وَمُنْذِرِينَ. Messengers as bearers of good news as well as of warning, in order that mankind should have no plea against Allah after the messengers. So the job of the messengers, the job of Musa, wa Ibrahim, wa Isa, wa Yahya, wa Zakaria, wa Prophet Muhammad, our Prophet Muhammad, alayhi salatu wassalam, is to tell people, obey Allah, you will be in the paradise. And if you disobey Allah, you'll be in the hellfire. This is their jobs. Their job. مُبَشِّرِينَ وَمُنْذِرِينَ. Then he said, وَأَوَّلُهُمْ نُوح. The first of them is نُوح. And the last messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What is the proof? إِنَّا أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ كَمَا أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى نُوحٍ وَالنَّبِيِّينَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ. The proof that the first of them is Nuh, Allah says, verily we have inspired you just as we inspired Nuh and the prophets after him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not say, as we inspired Adam and the messengers after him. He said Nuh and who came after him. So it means Nuh is the first messenger.
وكل أمة بعث الله إليها رسولا من نوح إلى محمد.
All has sent a messenger to every nation from Nuh until Muhammad. Why?
يأمرهم بعبادة الله وحده وينهام عن عبادة الطاغوت.
Who commanded them with the worship of Allah alone and forbade them to worship طاغوت.
طيب. So يعني many times people ask, what about that country? And there is one city in that country, and there is one village in that country. Will they be in the hellfire? They don't know anything about Islam. So how come Allah punished them and they did not know anything about Islam? Number one, Habib, please, brothers, sisters, don't think that you have mercy than, more than Allah. Sometimes some people, they want to be, they want to judge. Habibi, the judgment not for you, not for me. It's for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, don't think about the people who are in the jungles in Africa or in Asia. Think about yourself. Think about your surroundings. If you have any way to convey the da'wah for them, okay, do it. But you are sitting here and you are trying to confuse people. No, Islam is a wrong religion. Yani they claim that if you don't believe in Muhammad, then you will be in hellfire. What about the people who don't have electricity and they are very far and they don't have any idea about Muhammad? Habibi, no need to think about them. Think about your surroundings. Okay, if you can do something, a project to give them da'wah, do it. But you are sitting here and only you are trying to show that Islam is a wrong religion. A'udhu billah. So number one, this is not your duty. Number two, be sure that the Prophet Allah says, for every nation, ba'atna rasula. We have sent a messenger to convey the da'wah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, they got the risala, they got the message, they did not get the message. Okay, this is not your job. Your job is to convey the message of Allah to the people. I mean the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to people, because he told us to convey his da'wah, to continue this job. Okay, so please, brothers and sisters, many times we discuss and we have very long arguments about something useless. Only we are wasting the time. Okay, what about a person who lives in a very far area and he doesn't know anything about Islam? Then he died in a car accident. Will be he in the hellfire or in the paradise? I mean, why you are discussing this? And maybe you fight with your friend. Okay, what is the benefit? No need to discuss this issue. Khalas. Allah knows if this person knows Islam or not. Don't worry. Allah will not oppress anyone. Subhanahu wa ta'ala.
So he said, يَأْمُرُهُمْ بِعِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ وَحْدَ وَيَنْهَامْ عَنْ عِبَادَةِ الطَّاقُوتِ.
Okay, then he said, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا, he mentioned the ayah, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةِ الرَّسُولَ أَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ وَجِتَنِبُ الطَّاقُوتِ. And verily we have sent among every ummah a messenger proclaiming, worship Allah alone and keep away from طاغوت. Keep away from طاغوت. Okay, he will mention the طاغوت إن شاء الله. وافترض الله على جميع العباد الكفر بالطاغوت والإيمان بالله. Allah enjoined upon all of his slaves to have disbelief in the طاغوت and have إيمان in Allah. طيب, now, what is the meaning of طاغوت? What is the meaning of طاغوت? Sorry? False. Okay. He mentioned the definition of Ibn al-Qayyim. There are different definitions about Taghut. Okay. He gave us the definition from Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah. Ibn al-Qayyim is one of the great scholars. He is a student of Shaykh Islam Ibn Taymiyyah. Ibn al-Qayyim is one of the scholars of the 8th century. He was born in 691. He passed away 751. And his age was about 60 years old.
He's the from 691 to 751. He was, يعني, he's the most famous student of Sheikh Islam ibn Taymiyyah. Sheikh Islam Taymiyyah had many students like Ibn Mufluh, Al-Hanbali, Ibn Abdul Hadi, Muhammad ibn Abdul Hadi, also Hanbali, Ibn Kathir Shafi'i, Al-Dhahabi, Shafi'i also, Muhammad ibn Uthman Shafi'i, 748, Ibn Kathir 774. He had many, many students, but the famous one, the most famous one, Ibn al-Qayyim. Ibn al-Qayyim. At the beginning, he was Sufi, but alhamdulillah, he joined Ibn Taymiyyah, and alhamdulillah, he became Salafi scholars, one of the Salafi scholars, Ibn al-Qayyim. Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah. He said, what is the meaning of Taghut? He said, الطاغوت ما تجاوز به العبد حده من معبود أو متبوع أو مطاع. The Taghut is anything or anyone whose limit is exceeded by a person whether worshipped, followed or obeyed. Okay, the word Taghut, inshallah we are going to finish, inshallah, about 10 minutes or less than 10 minutes. Pay attention. I know you are very tired. Maybe for some of you got bored. Okay. But inshallah you are rewarded. Bidhnillah. Bidhnillah. Jazakumullah khair. What is the meaning of Taghut? I mean the origin of this word from Tughyan. What is the meaning of Tughyan? For example, the sea. The sea has a level. But sometimes, or maybe rarely, you know, you remember the tsunami. Okay, what happened? The water exceeded the normal level. صح? So this is called Tagha. Tagha. It went up higher than the normal level. This is called Tughyan. It went more than, it exceeded the normal level. As Allah says, Subhanahu wa ta'ala about Nuh, the people, and what happened with the people of Nuh. Inna lamma tagha al-ma' hamalnakum fil jariya. When the water exceeded the limit, okay, they went up on the ark. Nuh and his people. I mean, only the believers, not all of them. Only the believers. Few people with him. So this is called Taghut, Tughyan. Okay? So here he said, what is the meaning of Taghut? If there is a person, okay, he said, anyone whose limit is exceeded by a person, whether worshipped, followed, or obeyed. Then we call him Taghut. Like Fir'aun. Fir'aun is Taghut. Fir'aun is Taghut. Why? He was calling people to worship him. He said, Ana Rabbukum al-A'la. I am the most high Lord for you. A'udhu Billah. Okay, also the one who deals with magic. Or he's claiming the unseen. He's Taghut also. People go to him. Please, Sheikh, take this 100 pounds, 200 pounds. Tell me, where is my son? Where is my mobile? This person is Taghut. The one who claims the unseen. I know the unseen. I can't tell you about the future. A'udhu Billah. He's Taghut. Or if there is a person, okay, who's giving fatwa for people. Wrong fatwa. Intentionally wrong fatwa. And people following him. And they know that this is a bad sheikh. Okay? This sheikh is Taghut also. No problem. You can't drink khamr. Khamr is okay nowadays. It was haram, but nowadays it's okay. Because here the country is cold, so when you drink khamr, it will give you some energy. It's okay. Don't worry. Drink khamr. What about riba? No problem with riba. Sheikh, riba haram. It is in the Quran. It was haram, but now it's okay. What about boyfriends, girlfriends? No, it's okay. What is the problem? Alhamdulillah. This is like your sister, we can't trust. This is like your brother, you trust.
Okay, and people listen to him and they obey him. This person is taghut. Why? Because we are exceeding the limit in his obeying, in obeying him. We should obey him as a sheikh, okay, according to fatwa from the Quran and Sunnah, but not to change the halal to haram and the haram to halal. Okay, so this is taghut. Then he said, وَالطَّوَاغِيْتُ كَثِيرَةً. The taghut are many, and their heads are five. إبليس لعنه الله ومن عبد وهو راض ومن دعا الناس إلى عبادته ومن دعا شيئا من العلم الغيب ومن حكم بغير ما أنزل الله. Okay, who are the طواغيت? The examples, five examples of the طواغيت. He said the head, إبليس, may Allah curse him. Number two, one who is worshipped and pleased at that. Okay, there are people are worshipped, but they are not pleased. Like Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, he's not happy that people are worshipping him. Ali radiallahu ta'ala, some people worship Ali, but Ali is not happy that people worship him. So of course they are not taghut. But if there is a person, he can see people come to him and they make sujood for him, they fall prostrate before him, okay, and they slaughter with his name, and he is happy, he is silent, this man is taghut. طيب, one who calls the people to worship himself, we said, like Fir'aun, come and worship me, this is taghut. One who claims to have some knowledge of the unseen, the fortune teller, this is taghut. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, the one who knows the unseen. قُلْ لَهَا يَعْلَمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ الْغَيْبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Only Allah knows the unseen. Jibreel, our Prophet Muhammad, the companions, okay, all the people, all the angels don't know the unseen. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ حَكَمْ بِغَيْرِ مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهِ. And one who rules by other than what Allah has revealed. Okay, also this is taghut. Okay, I write a book. Okay, what is the ruling of riba, the ruling of adultery, the ruling of stealing, and the ruling of the things? Okay, yalla. You should follow. Khalas, leave the Quran. Don't listen to the Quran. Follow my book. Okay, this man or this woman is taghut. To follow the rules of other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We as Muslims, we have to follow the rules of Allah. We have to follow the rules of Allah. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. If you use the rules of other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then they are kafirun. Another ayah, fasiqun. Another ayah, ظالمون. Of course, there are details about this issue, but here, generally speaking from the Quran, they are kafir. And this person is taghut, the one who writes a book and he tells people, follow this book, don't follow the Quran. Okay, a'udhu billah, he's taghut. طيب. Then he said, what is the proof? لا إكراه في الدين قد تبين الرشد من الغي فمن يكفر بالطاغوت ويؤمن بالله. There is no compulsion in the religion. Verily, the right path has become distinct from the wrong path. Whoever disbelieves in taghut and believes in Allah, then he has grasped the most trustworthy handhold. So we should disbelieve in the taghut. We should disbelieve in the fortune teller, in Iblis, and these things. We should believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as our Lord. And he said, and this is the meaning of La ilaha illallah. If you remember, this is the meaning of La ilaha illallah. Negation, affirmation. You negate all the gods, you affirm only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then in the hadith he said, رَأْسُ الْأَمْرِ الْإِسْلَامِ. The head of the matter is Islam. وَعَمُودُهُ الصَّلَاةِ. Okay, its pillar is the prayer. وَذِرْوَةُ سَنَامِهِ الْجِهَادِ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. And its uppermost part is jihad in the cause of Allah. Okay, رَأْسُ الْأَمْرِ الْإِسْلَامِ. وَعَمُودُهُ الصَّلَاةِ. The pillar is the salah. وَذِرْوَةُ سَنَامِهِ. The uppermost, jihad fi sabilillah. طيب. At the end he said, وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ
وصلى الله على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. And Allah knows best, and may He praise and send peace upon Muhammad, his family, and his companions. And by this, alhamdulillah, we finished usul thalatha. Brothers, sisters, jazakum Allah khair. Alhamdulillah. Yani yesterday, I think 3 hours yesterday, or 3.5. And today also 3.5. صح؟ يعني total about 7 hours. Okay. So all praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we have read the book of al-usul thalatha, the three fundamentals. And inshallah, the reward will go to the Sheikh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. يعني, I don't think he imagined that people will read and will study his book. He passed away more than 200 years. Okay? يعني maybe he wrote this book before 300 years or 270 years. And until now, people are reading. Subhanallah, he's from Saudi Arabia. And now we are reading his book where in UK. He doesn't know UK. He doesn't know Leicester. He doesn't know Masjid al-Furqan. He doesn't know me. He doesn't know Sheikh Abdul Basit. But we are reading his book. We are studying his book. And many Muslims memorizing his book, subhanallah. Okay? So brothers, sisters, يعني, do the khair. Do the good things. Okay? And try your best to keep something in dunya, okay, last after your death, to bring you the hasanat. Maybe you can write a book. Maybe you can give a da'wah. If you teach someone Surah Al-Fatiha and this person is reciting Surah Al-Fatiha, you will get the reward even after your death if he is praying and reciting Surah Al-Fatiha. You don't know what will happen after that. Subhanallah. I remember when I was a student in faculty of medicine, there was a subject called the communication skills. So, subhanAllah, most of the students don't care about this subject. Most of them. Because there was no exam for this subject. SubhanAllah, I don't know why I like that subject. Okay, and I wrote some notes. Okay. What kind of notes? Only the titles. I took the titles and I put them. I put them in a note. I have a special note, like this note or bigger, A4 note. Okay. I write only the titles. Number one, this title, A, B, C, D, 3, E, F, G. Number two, A, B, C, D. I did not add any explanation, maybe a few notes. SubhanAllah. Okay, so some students, I have a note. Please, Brother Ahmed, we need your notes. I told them, only the titles. You can't study the title from the index. Go to the index and take the titles. No, we want your notes. SubhanAllah, okay. MashaAllah, I became famous. Everyone wants the notes of Ahmed. Ahmed al-Rumh, my name is Ahmed al-Rumh. Okay, yalla, photocopy, yalla. After maybe, I don't know, maybe 7 years, something like this. One of my colleagues was with me at work. I'm working now in the military hospital as a lab specialist. So this colleague told me, my daughter in the faculty of medicine now, and she's using your notes. After, I think, 7 years, 8 years, something, yeah, more or less. She's using, your daughter using my notes? Yes. Nothing in my notes, only the titles. Okay? So, subhanAllah, sometimes you do something you think this is nothing. Okay? But you don't know how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses your effort. Okay? So, please, brothers, sisters, try your best to do the good. I don't mean only to do the small things. Okay? Try to do as much as you can. Khair. Good. Spread the khair. Say good words. Write good words. Give da'wah. Behave good, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless. And also, brothers and sisters, don't forget to make the dua for our scholars. Okay, يعني we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him and our scholars, Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen, Sheikh Ibn Baz, Sheikh Al-Albani, okay, Imam Ahmed, Imam Abu Hanifa. Don't forget them in the dua. طيب, because, alhamdulillah, they left a lot of knowledge for us, and we are using their knowledge.
Now very easy, we check the internet, what they said, what they wrote, and we learn very easily. Okay, so don't forget them and the dua. And also, please, brothers and sisters, now you learn something. Okay, convey the knowledge that you know to the others. One of the brothers, a Mexican brother, he was in Kuwait for, I think, 2 years. But mashallah, very sincere, you feel, يعني, Allah alam about his sincerity, but you feel. نحسبه والله حسيبه. He is very sincere. MashaAllah. He likes to attend the halqa. Okay, so if there is a person who is very sincere or very serious about knowledge, I'm ready to spend time. I go to his place. So I was driving to his place. He doesn't have cars, khalas. I told him, I will come to your place. I will teach you Kitab Tawheed. Okay, so what is the language there in Mexico? Spanish. He knows English. Why? Because he has diploma, English. And I was explaining in English. MashaAllah. When I explain in English, he's writing in his note in Spanish. MashaAllah. I explain in English and he writes in Spanish. And now, MashaAllah, he's da'iyah. He went back to Mexico. And he's trying to start an Islamic center there. MashaAllah. Very simple man. It is difficult for him, or it is not easy for him to buy a note. He doesn't have enough money. But mashallah, he's trying to write, to attend. Mashallah, yani, and he's giving da'wah, mashallah, for his wife, his children, the other children from the first wife, because the first wife not Muslimah. Subhanallah. So please, brother, sister, convey this message to the others. Teach your family, your friends. Inshallah, later you will go, you will open another masjid. Maybe you travel to another masjid, another country. You know other languages. Okay? Yani some of you know not only the English, they know different languages. Okay? So you can't teach other language, you can't translate. So please, we brothers, sisters, we should work hard. The non-Muslims are working hard. Allah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ لِيَصُدُّ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Those who are disbelieving Allah spend their money to stop the religion of Allah. What about us, the Muslims? إِن تَكُونُوا تَأْلَمُونَ فَإِنَّهُمْ يَأْلَمُونَ كَمَا تَأْلَمُونَ وَتَرْجُونَ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَرْجُونَ. If you are suffering, also they are suffering. If you are getting pain, also they are getting the pain. But what is the difference? وَتَرْجُونَ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَرْجُونَ. But you are waiting something from Allah, they are not waiting that thing. It means you are striving toward the Jannah, for the paradise. Jazakum Allah khair, brothers, sisters. Tayyib, do you like to make a review 5 minutes before the exam? Or you like to have the exam? 5 minutes? 2 minutes? No review? Tayyib. You like to review from the book or from the exam itself? Huh? Yeah, from the exam. Because the Prophet ﷺ said, the one who makes life easy for people, may Allah make it easy for him. So I'm traveling tomorrow, so inshallah, I want to make the life easy for me. Okay. Tayyib, what is the age of Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Wahhab? You should know that. Birth and the death. 1115-1206. Tamam? The Sheikh started his book with 4 points. Sah? Ilm, knowledge. Amal, act upon this knowledge. Da'wah, calling to this knowledge. Sabr, patience. طيب. Then again, he mentioned 3 points. Tawheed rububiyyah, Tawheed uluhiyyah, Wala wal bara'. And he mentioned, Sheikh Rahimullah, what is the most important thing in Islam, or the most important order from Allah? Tawheed. And what is the worst sin? Shirk. And we mentioned, yani, I will not read all the questions, okay? We mentioned the types of ibadah. الخوف والمحبة والخوف والرجاء الرهبة والرغبة والخشوع. Okay, all these kinds are worship. But if you remember, we mentioned some of them can be from people. This is acceptable. For example, استعانة. استعانة. Okay, seeking help. Seeking help from people. Shirk. Not always shirk. It can be allowed if the person is present and he is alive and he can. Please, brother, come and hold this table with me. This is shirk. This is not shirk. Mashallah, he can come and hold it with me, carry it with me. So with conditions. So not all the kinds of seeking help is shirk. طيب. طيب. What are the conditions of لا إله إلا الله؟ العلم واليقين والقبول والانقياد فادري ما أقول والصدق والإخلاص والمحبة وفقك الله لما أحبه. Okay, you should recall the conditions of لا إله إلا الله. العلم, knowledge. اليقين, certainty. والقبول, acceptance. الانقياد, submission. المحبة, love. الصدق, truthfulness. طيب. والإخلاص, sincerity. جزاك الله خير. Okay. Then the Sheikh mentioned Islam, Iman, Ihsan. If you remember the three circles, okay, the ranks or the levels of Islam, the level of religion, Deen. The big circle, Brother Ahmed, this is a problem because he will tell Sheikh Abdul Basit. أنا قام أغششهم أقول لهم الإجابات إن شاء الله. طيب, this is quick review. طيب, so إسلام, إيمان, إحسان. طيب, when we talk, when we spoke about the to believe in Allah, the belief in Allah, we mention about the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how to prove the existence of Allah. We said that there are four proofs. دليل العقل, the logical proof. دليل الحس, like something, the feeling or the experimental proof. The الشرع, شريعة proof. دليل الفطرة. الفطرة, you know, something, the natural of the human being. The nature of the human being. Okay, what are the pillars of Islam? What are the pillars of Iman? You should know this question, صح? This is very easy. Al-Islam, the five pillars. Iman, six pillars. Very easy question. طيب. We spoke about the bid'ah, and we mentioned, there's one brother asked about the bid'ah. You asked about the bid'ah? Okay. Someone asked me about bid'ah. Where is this? Huh? Okay, you asked me about the bid'ah. Okay, so I mentioned 6 points about the bid'ah, صح? Okay, you should mention them in the exam if it is there. طيب. I did not say this is a question, but if. طيب. And also we spoke about the qadr, صح? And we mentioned the levels of qadr, or the 4 points of qadr. What are the 4 points of qadr? علم, كتابة, المشيئة, الخلق, knowledge, writing, the will of Allah, the creation. طيب, and we spoke about the books of Allah, the angels, the prophets, the messengers. طيب. Easy. This is easy. Easy. Okay, this is very easy. Okay, very easy, alhamdulillah. Sheikh Ahmed, when? Okay. Ma'am? Ibasakra. Zakallah. Okay. Can we start now? No rules for the exam, and you'll stay like this? Okay. You will not look at the paper of your friend? Do you have pen? Yalla. Let's go. هم يجلسون هكذا يعني ما ثقة بارك الله.
Mm-hmm.